Hello everyone, in the last video I show you how to drive a stepper motor with the help of the delay function. In this video I will show you what the problem is with using the delay function and how to solve this issue. Also, we will organize the stepper motor's functions into a class like we did with the sonars. And we are going to implement a function which will make the motor change direction after a certain amount of steps. Let's get started. For this project you will need the same components as last time. A breadboard, an Arduino, a 28 BYG48 stepper motor, a ULN2003A stepper motor driver, a 5V power supply, 6 male to female jumper wires, 1 male to male jumper wire, and a USB cable. So I mentioned there is a problem with the use of the delay function. Let's start with the simplest example. I want to turn on an LED for a second and off for another. Setting up the pin as output, turn the LED on, wait with the delay, turn off and wait again. Simple stuff and working as expected. If you don't know yet how to do this, I give you a link to my tutorial in the upper right corner. Now let's say I want two LEDs to blink, and I want the first to blink every sec and the second to blink every half sec. Based on the first example, I set up two pins as outputs, turn on the first for a sec and off for another. Turn on the second LED for half sec and off for another half. Not exactly as we specified, right? When you call the delay function, you basically tell your Arduino to do nothing. Don't listen to any sensor, don't give any command to motors or LEDs, just chill. In our example, we told the first LED to turn on and then do nothing for a second, and then turn off and do nothing for another second, and so on. What we wanted to do instead was to turn on the first LED if it was off, and turn it off if it was on, and do this every second. But, in the meantime, the Arduino should do other instructions, in our case, blink the other LED too. We want the Arduino to stay busy all the time, so let's try a different approach. We are going to have an if statement for each LED. If the difference between past time and the time when the LED last changed state is greater than or equal to the predefined blinking variable, then change the LED state. Otherwise, do nothing with this LED and store the next instruction. In our case, do a similar if statement with the next LED. Now you might ask, what does all of this has to do with our stepper motor? Remember, the stepping sequence we implemented last time had a delay in each step. So the Arduino does nothing after each step for a few milliseconds. This will be a problem if we want to do more than just to turn a single stepper motor. The implementation will be the same as the LED example. If the difference between the current time and the time when the motor last turned is greater than or equal to a given value, take one step. Otherwise, skip to the next instruction. Connecting the circuit is exactly the same as in the previous video, which you can watch in the upper right corner, so let's write the code. Before doing anything fancy, let's organize the code related to our stepper motor into a class. So let's start by creating the MyStepper class. We need to define its variables. It has 4 pins, also a value which defines how much time it should wait between each step, and another variable which keeps track of the state which the stepper is in. These variables will be integers. We will need the bool variable later, which will keep track of the turning's direction. Also, in order to leave the delay out of the stepping function, we will need a variable which stores the time of the motor's latest step. This variable will be an unsigned long, which is a 32-bit data type. Long means this is a 32-bit variable. Unsigned means it can't be a negative value. So these combined means that an unsigned long can take any integer value between 0 and 2 to the 32nd power, which is approximately 4300 million. I will tell you later why we need such a huge range of values. Okay, the variables and functions will be public, just like with the sonars. Now we have to decide what variables are needed when we initialize a stepper motor. We need to know which pins is it connected to and how much to wait between steps. Now we assign these values and setting up the pins as outputs and writing low to all of them. Also, we have to initialize the loop state as the first state of the stepping sequence, in our case this will be 1. Now to make sure we have set up the class properly, let's copy the code from the previous tutorial into a function and test it. Let's call it step. It will return nothing, so the return type will be void and it takes no inputs. Now we just have to change the variables accordingly. State to loop state, pins with lowercase p to uppercase p and the weight to step time. Also, make sure you write a semicolon at the end of the class. Now, we initialize our stepper before the void setup, and in the void loop, we just call its step function. Remember, the first four numbers are the pins of the motor, and the last number is the time between steps in milliseconds. I will attach the gear from the final project, just like the last time. No surprises. Now, let's implement this turning without the delay. We could do it in the step function, but I think it will be better if we make a new function, let's call it turn. This function will also return nothing, so the return type is void, but it will take an input. What this input will be needs some explanation. The Arduino has a function called millis. This function, when called, returns the number of milliseconds passed since our Arduino started its current program, and the returned value will be an unsigned long. Since this function measures time in milliseconds, you can imagine the stored number can get quite big, and this is why we need such a large variable. It can store time up to 2 to the 32nd power in milliseconds, which is approximately 50 days. At the beginning of every cycle of the void loop, we will update a variable with this millis function, and this variable will be the input to the above mentioned turn function. Now the fun part. We want to turn this motor when the difference between the current time and the last time stepped variable is greater than or equal to the step time. When this happens, we assign the current time to the last time stepped variable and call the step function. Also, don't forget to delete the delay in lines from the step function. Now let's try this. We have to update the current time variable at the start of every cycle of the void loop with the millis function. Also, change the call function from step to turn and give it the current time as input. Great, now we can test what is the difference between the two approaches. To see the difference, let's initialize two other stepper motors, each with different wait times between steps, 10 and 200 milliseconds. Do this with both versions. Call the turn function for all of these steppers and feed them the current time. They will get some stuff to turn, some previous failed projects, planetary gears. The designer of these gears is GearDownForWhat, he's a great guy, I will give you a link to him in the description. So let's see first with delay. Now without delay. As you can see, the one with delay does not work as we want. So with the new method, it looks like our Arduino is doing multiple tasks at once, which is obviously not the case, but it looks like that. Now let's implement the turning functionality. I just copied the same code from the previous tutorial, the one which included directions, and changed the variable names accordingly. Let's upload with direction equals high. And now with low. Awesome! Now let's include a function which changes the motor's rotational direction after a certain amount of steps. To achieve this, we need two more variables for each stepper. One to keep track of the motor's position, and one which determines how much step the motor should take before changing direction. The first will be called position, and the second is steps to make. Both of them will be unsigned long variables, for reasons to be discussed in a later video. So let's define these at the beginning of the MyStepper class, and at the initialization also. The position variable should be initialized as 1. If we start at 0, we will run into bugs. We want the stepper to change direction after it turned 90 degrees. After some research on the internet, I found out that this stepper takes approximately 2040 steps to turn around, so the steps to make will be the fourth of this. Now, to keep track of the rotation, we have to increase the position variable whenever the motor took a step when the direction was high. Also, decrease when the direction was low while the motor took a step. We could do this by increase or decrease in each step. This way, we have to write 8 lines of code. But we can do better than that if we write the increment right under the if statement and the decrement under the else. This way, we can save 6 lines of code, because we want to update the position variable every time the stepper motor takes a step in either direction. Now, we need a function which changes the motor's direction when it reaches its predefined boundaries. Let's call this function checkDirection, and it won't return any value, so it will be void type. Also, it takes no input. The motor's position starts at 1, so 0 will be a great boundary, and the other will be the steps to make variable. So when the motor's position is less than or equal to 0, or the position is greater than or equal to the steps to make variable, then assign the direction variable its opposite. A few words about this notation. We know that the direction is a bool variable, so it can only be one of the two things, 0 or 1. This exclamation mark means take the opposite of the direction variable. If it was 1, assign 0, and if it was 0, assign 1. One more thing left to do is to call this function at the appropriate place. The Arduino should check, before or after every step, if the motor is still rotating in the correct direction, so let's call it in the turn function after we call the step. Now it's done. We have to give one more variable for each stepper at their definition, namely their boundaries, and then we can upload. Something to think about. When we initialize the stepper motor as my stepper object, we gave them a constant time between each step, 3, 10, 2000 and so on milliseconds. If we want to change the stepper's acceleration, we just have to change the stepping time to be a function of steps, so it won't be constant anymore. So we can speed up, reach final speed and slow down when the motor reached its final position. This could be useful if we want to position something precisely. Maybe I will do a video about making a stepper class which has acceleration incorporated, but for the radar we won't need it. That was a lot to absorb, so if you have any question, feel free to ask me. Next time I will show you how to filter any signal and the better driving method for the stepper. If you got interested in doing these projects and want to follow along, I give you links to the kits I use in the description below, so you can have the exact same components I have. If you have any question, observation or feedback, please leave a comment below. Also, if you liked this video, let me know by like, share and subscribe. Thank you and see you in the next episode.